What's going on, everybody? It's Wednesday. It's time for another installment of Fatal Vision. How you doing there? Today we're going to be taking a look at Tin Can by Tin Can Studios. And what got me interested in this was is that it's supposed to offer a unique playthrough every single time you try it out. The story is about a technical engineer who's on a star cruiser that's about to explode. He hops on an escape pod, and this game just pretty much details the trials and tribulations that he's going to have to go through inside that little tin can. So yeah, grab a drink. Let's play some damn games. Yeah, I've always liked spacey stuff, and I mean, to me, normally we're looking at, you know, we're in the dark and boo horror ghost story shit, but I think this is a different kind of horror, because you've always seen horror movies where someone's like, well, if I was in this situation, this is what I would do, and right here, this is the perfect, what would you do if you were in this situation type of thing? Because you're not like an engineer who knows what the hell he's doing. This game actually focuses on your own personal common sense and your own logic, you know, in this situation. Like me personally, I'm a dope. I don't know about nuclear reactors and shit like that, but it asks a very important question. If everything started going to hell in this little safety pod, would you just lay down and die, or would you try to figure everything out? Collision aware, brace for impact. Oh no. Shit. Oh, here we go. We can grip on like we're in a subway car. Oh, shit. Not good. Alright, something just dinged. And I don't think my hot pocket's done. Something happened. Now, right now, it's so in early development that they don't have like an ending strategy to this one. You know, they're just making a game out of how long can you last. And it's like, well, why would you play a game where you're just gonna die anyway? I actually find it kind of interesting. How long would you last? And they are working on having an ending where you do wind up getting rescued. But this is a one-man development, and what they've put together, I'm really kind of liking the idea of it. It's a really interesting topic, and I'm kind of glad that I didn't get hit by that goddamn thing. I'm just kind of worried about what's going to break next. But that's the unique aspect of this, is that something else is going to break the next time I play it. And it's just, what are you going to do? Are you going to figure it out? Are you just going to give up? Like me personally, I'm claustrophobic, so being stuck in this, I'd be freaking the hell out. There's our gravity generator. There's the main generator, which we don't want to lose. Main logic computer. My mouse is just acting up right now. I can imagine this being in VR, too. So congratulations on your purchase of a Fissionator Model 1952. Alright, we got the values table, systems list, components list, error codes, which I'm sure we're going to have to be going through a lot of. Yeah, so if you had a friend playing with you, you would have to read the error codes off to them, and then they would read it back to you. I kind of like that idea. It's like you have tech support. That's cool. All right, so here's this. We got an atomic pile temperature. I'm assuming that's our core. We got 2 meters here, so red, I'm assuming, is the output, and blue is where it needs to be at. We got O2, CO2, nitrogen levels, pressure, atmospheric temperature, how breathable the air is. And plus, it explains all this for you right here. Here's the main generator. This is severe radiation poisoning if it's handled without problem. Oh, that's good to know. Jesus. Right, so let's take a look at this. Alright, so it needs to be within these levels here. Change the channel. Do I get HBO? It's an error list, so at the very least we'll... I don't know, there's a meter with that. We've got the oxygen generator, which is probably a life support. We got a master caution. Low pump, empty bottle, low oxygen. Oh, shit. Alright, so we'll swap that out. And then we've got carbon dioxide scrubber and the pressure generator. That's full. And unless I failed science class way too many times, I'm going to go out on a limb and assume that it works on a system of it'll drain the CO2 out of this and filter it, and it'll go into the O2 canister. So we just have to swap those out periodically, and we should be good. All right, so problem here is that we have low oxygen production because the pump is fucked. Great. Now, once again, this is probably a result of the asteroid impact. This would not happen the second time that I played through this. Like, this system could wind up getting screwed, or God forbid the generator gets screwed up, or... All right, here's the logic system. Alright, what can I do about the pump? Wait, here we go. Repair station. Required part. Okay, so we're going to need to find spare parts. I don't have spare parts. Great. Yeah, see, that's the problem. I'm already figuring this out, where you're going to have to probably sacrifice parts from other systems. Shit, what else would have a pump? Because I don't want to take anything out of these things, because they're all critical life things. Alright, so this is the climate control. I'm assuming this is going to be ultra-realistic and you have to turn things off before you just arbitrarily take it upon yourself to yank things out, because that'll wind up breaking it in the process too if you're going to swap something out. Let's turn you off, and we'll swap out the pumps. There we go. And I also saw the little battery thing there. So you can go in there. You might be a piece of shit, but I think I can deal with the air being a little warm. Let's hope nothing else goes wrong. We got a battery charger here. And that powers that. Alright, let's take a look at the gravity generator. The main generator, make sure there's no problems here. Alright, beautiful. I mean, gravity we can live without. No damage here, which is really good. I don't want to have the power output get screwed up here. Alright, main lights, emergency lights. Yeah, that's probably what it is. It's like, if I don't have the parts, I'd have to take the parts out of the lights, dismantle them to have, like, the value go up just enough so that I can repair that. I like the idea of it, but I don't like the idea of it being in the very beginning of the game. Can't just completely throw someone to the wolves like that. Alright, what else we got in this technical manual here? We got the oxygen generator, the CO2 scrubber. Okay, so it does explain everything to you nicely. And I'm also seeing, like, what will happen if this goes wrong. So, I like that. We got the components list. These are all the parts. So, at least it's detailed. And plus all the error codes and the causes and probable consequences. And I really gotta break this. Alright, so just as long as nothing else goes wrong, which I'm sure it will. Yeah, so how's everybody's week going? Hopefully you're all doing good. It's been a pretty quiet week. And after I'm done recording this, I'm gonna sit down and start recording gameplay footage for Fatal Frame. Can't wait to start doing conventional reviews again. Like, I really miss doing it. That whole Legacy of Kain thing kind of broke me for a bit. I had to take a step just back from it, because I had already beaten it. I started scripting it again, then I switched laptops, and then I had to beat the game over again. And, you know, 50 hours of gameplay, recording it, beating it on a linear story, and then having to go back and do that shit again? No. Same thing that happened with the Resident Evil things, where I had to go back and re-record Resident Evil 2's playthrough. I didn't want to do it again. Shit, Ice Nebula. Cold. Alright, it's going to freeze up the generator. Alright, so what I think I can do here is... Alright, we'll shut everything off. Except for emergency lighting. And hopefully... the excess energy that's being produced... can run on battery for a bit. I think. and we'll leave the gravity generator running, because if that goes south, I'll be completely fucked. Right, we'll turn off climate control, too. I think that'll actually help heat things up. Alright, the ideal temperature that I'm going to need is the blue, and it's only producing the red. Shit. Alright, the only thing I can really do is just try to monitor these levels. I'm probably going to need the CO2 scrubber running, though. Because if the CO2 gets way too high, I'm going to be completely fucked. What now? Into a AR-22. Alright. Alright, where's Into A? AR-22 is a dirty filter. You gotta clean that out. I saw another filter down here, too. Alright, I think that might be the problem. Alright, where's N2OA? N2OA, N2OA. Say that 5 times fast. Alright, I'm dying. Calm down, calm down, calm down. 071H, what the hell's that? I'm running out of oxygen. I can't fucking see. 071H. What is that? Pod too low oxygen. Alright, that's getting fixed. I think it just takes a minute for it to kick up. We're gonna need the pressure fixed up too, because if that gets too high, I'll just get crushed. How are we doing on power generation here? You know, you would think that operating these things would cause more power to be put out, which would in turn heat it up. You know, in theory, I could just yank the processor out, and then that would cause heat fluctuations. But I think that would actually wind up screwing it up even more. Even just having the thing down would probably raise heat levels too. But I'm also kind of worried about just taxing the system way too much, because if it's putting out too much power, I think I saw some these look like power transformers. Yeah, so if it was too much power, it would go to the power transformers and overheat them and burn them out, and then I would have to fix those, which I don't have the spare parts to do it. I'd be fucked. I think at the very least this is something where we're going to have to deal with some just mild discomfort, you know? But it looks like N2NOA... Where's the book? It means it's running on battery, which is fine. But I saw the charger over here. So once this passes, I'll just take the batteries out and I'll recharge them. And we should be good. Let's give it a little boost. Jesus. You know, I like this. And for a one-man development thing, I see a lot of potential in this. I mean, I think right now I'm getting off kind of lucky that I'm able to manage this stuff. But I can imagine if shit really hits the fan, how tense it'll be. I mean, imagine the gravity runs out and then you're floating around. You gotta grab onto the handles and kind of pull yourself along. I don't hear any more ice cracking, so I think we're good. It's going to take a minute for that thing to heat up. But I think we can turn the climate control back on. I think we can turn the lights back on. Alright, everything is in good ranges. Atomic pile's going back up, temperature-wise. Alright, so... we just got to wait for it to get off of those batteries. Which it should be doing. Alright, we made it through the ice nebula. Yeah, like I said, theoretically you can just pull that processor out. But I don't know if that would work, and I think that would wind up causing way more damage. Alright. So let's charge these batteries here. What actually worries the shit out of me is the idea that an ion storm would happen, because that would fry all the electronics. What if that actually happened? Like, that's not good. I'm kind of paranoid thinking about it, because if that fries everything, it'll fry the batteries. So I would just turn off the main power, right? I mean, Jesus, even just charging it, charging a battery, is kind of dicking me up here. These are at decent levels. They are going down, but... Well, that worries me. Should I yank all the batteries out? Jesus. Look at all that consumption just from charging a friggin' battery. That's nuts. And gravity's coming back. There it is. Oh, calm down. Stop. There's no errors. Oh, shit. This is like the worst time for this to happen, too. So what do? I mean, like, shit. As long as I stay on top of this, I think I'll be okay. I don't think many things took a hit from that. Kind of want to keep some spare batteries on hand. Shit. I should probably swap these out. These levels are still pretty high. Battery on that is completely drained. This is turned on, right? I just saw a spark come out of there. Something was wrong with that. Oh no. That's kind of critical. I feel like I want to keep some spare batteries around, but I don't have any spares. Canisters low. Of course. Trying to swap this out in zero G. This isn't much better. Fucking ADD. It's on. It should be functioning. Right, I don't have much choice here. Shut up! Shut up! Shut up! This thing is taking forever to charge. Alright, we didn't do too bad there. Turn you back on, though. Kind of need you. Why is everything on? Oh, because it's charging. throw on. Probably fried something. Uh-oh. What would the impact do here? Nothing, thankfully. That's... Oh my god, that is so... typical. This is turned on. Oh shit, that's overheated. Power transformer's totally fucked. Just calm down, will ya? That's because the pump is fucked here. Oh man. Well, at least this is functioning, right? I hope. I think it's because the temperature seems to be normal. It's 71 degrees in here. This thing is just way overheated. But it looks like it's cooling down. I guess you just can't, like, mass charge batteries. Is this even going down? Well, that was empty, so... don't want that floating around if everything goes wrong. This has got a low battery too. What the hell is going wrong with this thing already? Repair station is offline. Oh. Alright. It's cooled down. Now charge that shit. Oh my god. No, wait, wait, wait. Get the battery out. Get the battery out. I gotta take out the fucking power transformers. No, no, no. Give me my fucking gravity back. You fucking thing. It's gonna fry everything, you son of a... No, 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 no! Fucker! Watch, it fried everything. And I can't move because of this goddamn... Why is gravity not working? And now the lights are off. It's because I turned the generator off. I mean, I think theoretically if I just turned off the power, it'll be okay. I hope. I think we might be safe, so I think I can start turning things back on. Right, you close. I need that goddamn gravity though, because without the gravity, I'm just lost. Can't get anywhere. We've got emergency lighting going. Oh, calm down. All right, I'm freezing to death. That'll take a minute. Shit. working on it. This is out of oxygen. I know, I get it. I'm working on it, you fucking Momo. I can't. It's not much, but it's going to have to do for now. Did I get the power generator back? I think it's fried. Just try to even things out. Just work with me here. Work with me. Clean the filters a little. Come on, come on, come on. I'm working on it. I'm working on it. You get started up. I think the gravity's finally starting to even out a little bit. We gotta get started on getting more oxygen, so. Died from hypoxia. Fuck! But I made it 26 minutes and 18 seconds, which is really important here. Ah, damn. Yeah, we all know that this is a hopeless thing right now at this point, but I do find this a really interesting subject, and I think this could wind up being pretty scary just on the notion that, once again, you're isolated, you're alone, you're completely stuck in this little tin can. And I like the way that things are coming together, especially for an early access game that's already gone through one major update that's fixed a lot of the initial issues. It's got a pretty active amount of people that are playing this and enjoying it and sharing thoughts online with each other, which I like as well. I'd say that there's a lot of potential behind this, and I mean, if this is something that you're not really into, I get it, but if this is something that's right up your alley, I'd have to say that the pluses behind it is that it's a great concept, it seems to function very, very well, and this could go places. This would actually make a pretty decent game, where I like that party mode, where you can hang out with somebody and have them act like tech support and read off issues to you. This is interesting. I like that. So, yeah, it's got a lot of potential. I'd have to say a negative behind it is that I really can't seem to find too many, except for maybe just the fact that you should start off with some amount of spare parts to begin with, that you could repair stuff as it goes wrong, and then as the journey goes along, you start running out and going, oh shit, what can I get rid of to try to fix this? That would kind of even things out a little bit, because just the initial difficulty could be intimidating for some people. But even if you don't want to just have that difficulty, you can do the sandbox mode, which from what I've seen, it just seems like there's no incidents that happen. You know, the only thing that can kill you is yourself. So, yeah, overall, I like the idea. And I respect the fact that there's one person that's working on this. And for one person working on this, I'd say they've done a pretty damn good job. Price tag's not intimidating at all, but the difficulty just might be. And on that note, that's just about gonna do it for me. So as always, thank you so much for dropping by and inviting me in your day like this. I hope you're having a good week, and I'll check in on you Friday with another ROM hack review. And if I don't see you Friday, hopefully we can finally get some streaming going on. It's just haven't been able to find the opportunity to do it. And if I don't see you on Friday or Saturday or Sunday, I'll see you next Wednesday with another installment of Fatal Vision. So you guys have a good week, and I'll see you then. So Juan Fita saying, bye-bye now.